Hello, everyone, and welcome to the breakout BIM interoperability with BricsCAD BIM V24. I am Fleur Dooms, EMEA Technical Pre-Sales Lead, and I am going to walk you through this session. First of all, what did we do in BricsCAD BIM V24? We improved interoperability so that you can collaborate with ease in an open BIM approach. You can do that by importing or exporting from or to IFC or RVT. How did we do this? We added extra functionality to the existing interoperability options, such as the IFC 4 reference view. We also added a new tool to validate IFC files. We unified the input of IFC properties, and with smart visibility rules on IFC properties, you can easily input them. We also included a first beta of RVT exports. So, why did we do this? Well, our mission is simple. Make your model transfer as flawless as possible. We want to ensure IFC quality. We want to make sure that you can add IFC data easily and exports to IFC flexibly. And if IFC would not be enough, you can easily respond to the need for proprietary output with Bricsys RVT export included as beta feature in BricsCAD BIM V24.
For whom did we make this?
Well, you can say that this is for all BIM coordinators in the AEC industries. And when would you want to use which interoperability option? IFC 2x3 or IFC 4 design transfer is there for you when you need to continue your design with high accuracy and want to maintain small file sizes. IFC 4 reference view is there when other tools cannot read the design transfer and when no properties are needed. You can simply export geometry as reference or underlay to RVT directly. So, all in all, exchange models and data flexibly by using BricsCAD, a professional CAD software that cares for BIM interoperability. So let's dive in. Here you see a model created in BricsCAD BIM. When I select one of the walls in this project, I can see that this has the IFC properties and classification. So let's start with the IFC reference view. Hit the export button and you'll see in V24 that there is a new option to export to IFC 4 reference view. Simply give the file a name. Hit the save button. Then we can see in any IFC viewer that the information that we saw previously in BricsCAD is also present inside the IFC model. If we then go to the properties of the overall model, we can easily see that this one has as a view definition a reference view. Also, inside the file description, when the IFC is opened with a text editor, you can simply view that this is now an IFC 4 reference view schema. You can also see there's a log file that sits next to your exported IFC. So let's dive a little bit deeper into this IFC 4 reference view and see what it actually means. What is the difference between the IFC design transfer view that we can find next to the IFC reference view? Well, IFC reference view enables you to make a simplified version of your model. It is the IFC 4 reference view that the IFC 4 certified programs are validated against. So this is why we implemented the reference view export, so that more programs can read the simplified file. Let's open the IFC design transfer. This is what BricsCAD BIM had in the past as default IFC output format and see how it differs from the IFC reference. You can see that the IFC 4 design transfer was not imported correctly in this IFC viewer. But the IFC reference view looks way better. Now let's see how BricsCAD handles this. Because in essence, the design transfer is still the best way to transfer your models in a full way without simplification. As you can see, when this curved geometry is imported back into BricsCAD, the IFC 4 design transfer view is actually more accurate. However, the IFC 4 reference view is a simplification or an approximation of certain curved geometry. This makes that more programs can read it, especially because they are certified against this reference view schema. Now, let's dive a little bit deeper in the unified IFC namespace. When you open the BIM properties, you can see there is now one namespace activated by default, which is the IFC namespace. What does this mean? The simplified namespace is introduced to reduce complexity for our users. Simply said, it means that you can input IFC properties in one main namespace and you don't have to choose upfront or worry about which IFC version you'll export to. Upon export to IFC 2x3, the unified IFC properties will be mapped towards the IFC 2x3 properties. And same applies for IFC 4. As a note, the unified IFC namespace is based on the IFC 4 schema. So this is what it will resemble the most. But upon export to IFC 2x3, a mapping will happen automatically by BricsCAD. So that only upon exporting, you need to decide what IFC type you want to use. As you can see in this IFC, the status property is not included because the status property is only an IFC 4 property. And I export it to IFC 2x3. Now, how do you make use of this unified namespace? Well, simply create a new project with a BIM millimeter template, for instance, and you will have in the BIM properties the new unified IFC namespace. Another new tool is the IFC Validate tool. Although BricsCAD BIM has a very extensive and qualitative IFC import, the result depends heavily on the quality of the received IFC file. IFC Validate will allow you to check if the IFC file is correct according to the IFC standards. After this validation, you can still choose to continue with the IFC file import or not. And you will see that even when the file reports errors in the command line, the entities are imported as good as possible by BricsCAD. But know that some issues just cannot be resolved, and then consulting the log file might come in handy. If we open the log file that is placed next to our original IFC, we see that all found issues are listed alongside the places where they were found. This easily lets you find back where the problems are located. Note that in the IFC settings, you can also enable automatic IFC validation upon export. As you can see, we are truly committed to our IFC quality. Another improvement we did in V24 is to make sure that property sets can be enabled and disabled automatically based on an attribute that is set in your properties. For instance, if we show all the covering property sets, then we see that there is a ceiling covering and a floor covering extra property set. So let's classify the suspended ceiling as a covering. Do remember that in BricsCAD BIM V23, we already added a bunch of extra classifications for you to choose from based on the IFC 4 schema. If now we classify this object as a covering, we see that in the properties we indeed have a covering. Now the new functionality in V24 is as follows. If I give a covering type, for instance ceiling, to my covering, then you will see that the property set covering ceiling is automatically shown as I set this attribute on ceiling. The same applies if I would make it a floor covering or if I would make a user-defined covering. Then an open text field appears at my cursor. Finally, while in BricsCAD BIM V23 we already had RVT and RFA import, with V24, we added a beta feature that can even export to the Revit RVT format. Currently, this beta comes with a few limitations. For instance, it only allows you to export the geometry with a limited set of classifications. It will still transfer your levels and stories, and transparency is only carried over if defined on solid level. Furthermore, we only export to Revit 2023 for now. And you will get non-editable geometry in Revit. You will also not get the properties and no compositions. And all entities on hidden and frozen layers are included in the Revit export as well. You will only get the 3D geometry, no 2D, which also means that you cannot export grids at the moment. We only allow Revit export if the BricsCAD file contains only one building in the spatial locations, as Revit only supports one building per file. Despite the current limitations, this work in progress, or beta version like we say, is constantly being polished, and we would appreciate your early feedback. Now, as soon as we open the drawing in Revit, we can actually see that this RVT export beta version did a pretty good job. If now, for instance, I define an extra floor level to which I attach a plan view, I can simply open the plan and see how our Revit export worked. So This concluded the BIM interoperability with BricsCAD BIM V24 session. You saw how we improved interoperability and with which features. You also saw why we did this. Namely, we want to make your model transfer as flawless as possible. Also, you saw that we added the beta feature for Revit Export when IFC is not enough. You saw that BIM coordinators in all AEC industries can make use of this tool. And to conclude, I want to reiterate for which uses you better use what. IFC 2x3 or IFC 4 design transfer is interesting when you need to continue modeling afterwards in another program. IFC 4 reference view is mostly interesting when you want to be sure that all geometry is readable by the other program, as we saw that some programs do not support the full design transfer view. Finally, if you want to simply export the geometry or want to give our Revit Export beta a try, then try out our Revit Export included in V24 and see for yourself how it can improve your workflow. I hope this convinced you that BricsCAD BIM can flexibly exchange models and data through IFC or Revit format. If you want to see even more of BricsCAD BIM V24, then watch these breakouts. You can find how to go quickly from 2D to 3D with BricsCAD V24 in Rita's session, or how you can go from scan to plan or BIM in my other session. Alternatively, see for yourself what the future of our scan to BIM automation holds, or discover how our construction detail management tools can boost your workflow in Dimitris' sessions. This was the BIM interoperability with BricsCAD V24 session. Thank you for your attention, and certainly scan the QR codes to try BricsCAD for yourself.